Hi, my name is Ariella, and today we are building this shelf.
As some of you may know, I don't own a table, so I again had my pieces precut in the home center. For the size, you need 6¾ inches wide and 3/8 thick plywood. You need to cut 2 48-inch long pieces and 14 pieces 6-inch long. The back panel and the shelves are made of 3/4-inch plywood. The shelves are 6 inches wide and 40 3/4 inches long. The back panel is 40 by 48 inches. The sides can also be made from 3/4-inch plywood. You just need to cut the dados with a tool of your choice. I wanted to use dados to affix the shelves, but I'm not that comfortable with routers yet, so I decided to try something else in making them. I made the true dados on the sides by attaching the small pieces on the longer ones with glue and brad nails. I used a scrap piece of 3/4-inch plywood to space the dados on the sides. Remember to use enough wood glue and nails in the glue up. I should have used a piece of paper to make the dados just a bit wider to make the attaching the shelves more easy. I tried to use brad nails to attach the shelves to the sides, but my air compressor doesn't create enough pressure, so the nails were left sticking quite a bit. I believe I have some problem with my pressure regulator, so I need to check that out in the near future. When the brad nails didn't quite work out, I resorted to use number 8 screws to attach the shelves. I drilled pilot holes from the inside, and I then flipped the pieces around and used backwards running a countersinking drill bit to make countersinks for the screws. I've been told that running the countersinking bit backwards helps with the tear out. Glue up of the shelves was a bit of a hassle because of the stuck dados. I had to use some force to persuade the joints to close. I don't have any long clamp, so I had to use hammer. Bit brutal, but it worked out in the end. I used 3 screw-spaced end. With the sides being 3/4 inches wider than the shelf, there's a space for the back panel to be recessed on the back. The sides will cover the back panel on the edges. I used some number 8 screws to attach the back panel to the shelves. Screwing the back to the shelves helps prevent sagging in the future, not that there will be that much load on the shelves. I wanted to hide the screw heads on the side, so I used some filler to do that. I also had some gaps and inconsistencies on the edges, so I used filler on those too. I also used some acrylic caulking in the inside of the shelves to hide some gaps. Remember to use caulking that can be painted over afterwards. I sanded everything to remove any excess filler and pencil marks before painting the shelf.
I gave this shelf 2 coats of paint, but I won't be showing you the installation of this shelf because I made this for a friend who has a garage. He will be storing his oil filters in the shelf. Okay, thank you for watching. Leave a like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you have anything to ask. Thank you for watching. Bye.